causing anything from a mild sunburn to heat stress or skin cancer, sun exposure in the workplace is something employers need to pay attention to at this time of year. Fortunately, sun exposure is a largely preventable hazard, and there are a number of relatively simple things employers can do to protect their employees.
Recent estimates indicate there's around 4,500 cases of skin cancer due to occupational exposure directly. That's more cases than asbestos, diesel particulate matter exposure, and silica exposure combined.
Measures like long sleeves, pants, and hats are good ways to protect employees from sunburn. However, they could raise the risk of heat stress. Tenkate says employers have to balance maximum protection with the realities of the job.
I think overall what we find is most employers would say, yes, we know that people are getting exposed to the sun. You can't eliminate the sun and you can't substitute the sun, but you can put in place your other control measures that are administrative controls, engineering controls, and personal protective equipment. If someone could have a 1 hour work break in the middle of the day in shade, their overall UV exposure or ultraviolet radiation exposure from the sun decreases between 20% and 40%.
Similar to midday breaks in the shade, sunglasses and sunscreen are easy ways to protect employees from the risk of too much sun exposure.
We want workplaces to take that approach of setting in place good policy and then backing that up through a rigorous risk assessment process, and then looking at what are the control measures that they can take to manage the worker exposures that are specific to their workplace.